Good morning, everyone. I am Sonam from Nursing Department in RPIIT Medical and Technical Campus. Otosclerosis. Today, the topic is otosclerosis. First is, what is otosclerosis? Otosclerosis or hardening of the ear results from the formation of an abnormal spongy bone like bone growth along the stapes in the middle ear. With the new bone growth, the stapes become immobile, prevents transmission as sound vibration into the ear, leading to conductive hearing loss. Otosclerosis usually affects the both ears. Next is classification. It is two types, histological and clinical. First is, what is histological? This type of otosclerosis does not produce any symptoms during life, like that tinnitus, dizziness, vertigo, hearing loss, but it revealed only at post-mortem. Second is clinical otosclerosis. There are three subtypes, which are first stage, step dial otosclerosis, next stage, cochlear otosclerosis, and third is mixed otosclerosis. First, what is step dial otosclerosis? In that, focus may produce alkalosis of the membranous nucleus. And in second, cochlear otosclerosis, process encroaches upon the membranous membrane, producing sensorineural deafness. Next is mixed otosclerosis. Causes: both fixations of the stapes as well as in involvement of the membrane, so that there are mixed hearing loss. Next is causes. What are the causes? There are many causes, like a genetic factor, viral infection, measles, and other ear disease conditions like tinnitus and tumors, etc. Next is clinical manifestations: hearing loss, dizziness, tinnitus. Tinnitus means ringing or buzzing noise in one or both ears that may be constant or comes and go, often associated with hearing loss. Next is snoring, buzzing the ear, vertigo. Vertigo is a sudden onset of unsteadiness, pallor, or anxiety. This may manifest as the child falling and refusing to walk and sleep. Next is headache and ear ache. Next is diagnosis and evaluations of otosclerosis. First, we collect the history of the patient, like that, as well as surgical and medical history. Next is physical examination and doing some tests like tuning fork test and audiometry test. What do you mean by tuning fork test? Tuning fork test is also known as Weber test and Rennie test. In this test, the doctor strike a tuning fork and place it on the mastoid bone behind one ear. After that, when you can no longer hear the sound, you signal to the doctor. Then the doctor moves the tuning fork next to your ear canal. When you can no longer hear that sound, you once again signal the doctor. After that, the doctor record the length of time you hear each sound. Next is audiometry test. In audiometry test, a neurological test of auditory brainstem function, in which we test how well your hearing function. It tests both the intensity and tone of sound balance. Next step, tympanosynthesis fluid for middle ear sent for culture. CT scan, for CT scan, collections of fluid, ear fluid in ears, mastoid region, abscess formations. MRI, evaluations of tumor and soft tissue. Audiography, to assess hearing loss. Next time, management. How we manage the otosclerosis? Otosclerosis may slowly get worse. The condition may not require treatment until you having severe hearing problem. Medications such as fluoride, calcium, or vitamin D may help to slow the hearing loss, but the benefits have not yet been proved. No non-medical treatment exists for this form of deafness, but amplification with a hearing aid may be helpful. Administer some analgesic drugs for the pain like ibuprofen, oxycodone and PCM. Hearing aid may be used to treat the hearing loss. General measures, we take some steps like that, avoidance of noiseful environment, sideline position, continuous applications of medications and high protein diet. Surgical management, there are two types of surgery. First is stepdectomy and next is stepglottis. Stepdectomy, in that the removal of portions of the telglottic steps, foot plates of steps or complete removal of the steps and the implant with prosthesis to maintain suitable conduction. Next is stepglottis. Modern surgery called stepglottis is performed by drilling a small hole in the steps, foot plates with micro drill or lasers, and the insertion of a piston-like prosthesis. Next is what we do the nursing assessment in otosclerosis, first history of onset and prognosis of symptoms, extent of hearing loss by auditory, Rennie test, for that to evaluate loss of air conduction and Weber test. Next is some complications arise. First is complete deafness, second nerve damage, third infection, dizziness, pain or blood clot in the ear after surgery. Thank you.